Sacramento. We're the Flamin Groovies. And we are here to play for you tonight. Crazy sound, and it never stopped the rocking until the moon went down. I said it sounds so sweet, I had to take me a chance. I rose out of my seat, I just had to dance. I saw the move of my feet, I wrote a clap of my hand. I said the joint was a rocking, going round and round. Yeah, really and rocking. What a great sound. And it never stopped the rocking till the moon went down. I said the joint was a rocking, going round and round. Yeah, really and rocking.
yeah, 12 o'clock. Yeah, the place was packed. The front doors was locked. I said the place was packed. And when the police knocked, those doors flew back. But they kept on knocking.
Baby, turn around.
Wow, thanks. This one's written by an old blues guy that I love and nobody's heard of. If the Rolling Stones had heard of this guy, they would have ripped him off too instead of Robert Johnson. But anyway, this is called Married Woman.
song I wrote a long time ago. It had a different title, and it was totally different lyrics. The song was called The Blues from Phyllis. And it's about a guy who was going blind because he got syphilis. So when we got signed to United Artists, they kind of said, hey, could you change the subject of the song? So me and Chris Wilson, rewrote it and called it Don't Put Me On. Because when I was in a rep company back in 68, acting, there was an English lady, a lovely woman, named Frankie V. Phipps Wilson. And Frankie always used to say, don't put me on, it puts me off, you know, in a Cockney accent. So anyway, this one's called Don't Put Me On.
Hey, Bobby, put some serial vocal on my witch over here.
And up here, and some CBS back here as well, please.
What the fuck, man? Help me out.
Please.
Where are you?
Thank you. Yeah.
I gotta tell you, this fucking song is like gum on my fucking shoe. You know what I mean? I mean, I've been playing it for 50 fucking years, and I'm still not tired of it. And I'm so glad you guys like it. It's called Shake Some Action. We'll be right back. This one is a song written a long, long time ago, and was actually conceived at the Big Sur Folk Festival with my dear old friend Kim Fowley. It was really one funny guy. Okay. Yeah, he was walking around the Big Sur Festival. Me and him were on acid. Yeah, we had taken some white lightning, and 1,500 mics, and Kim kept asking everyone, including Linda Ronstadt, where he could get some teenage head at the festival. As if there was a booth where you could go and get teenage head. Yeah. Anyway, I laughed so hard. I laughed for 8 hours, and the next day when I woke up, my mouth was wide open. I couldn't close it for an hour. And I told my friend Roy Looney about it, and we wrote the song Teenage Head, because we, at that point, were friends with Jimmy Page and the Led Zeppelin guys. And we were the first to know about them. This was 6 months before they came out. And so I said to Roy, I said, let's write it like the mothers of invention doing Led Zeppelin. Okay. And we called it Teenage Head.
California born and raised.
This one's about Coke, right?
Yeah, this one's about Coke. And you know, the true facts about the wonder drug known as cocaine has never been really brought to the surface.
I just like the way it smells.
I'm going to be 75 on Thursday. And I've been snorting coke since 1969, okay? So, I never went into detox. I never OD'd. And I stopped doing crack after 2 years, just like that, because I blew so much smoke out of my mouth one day. I thought my house was on fucking fire, you know? And then I heard fire engines down, two blocks down. And then the phone rang, and I thought, oh my God, my mom's dying. And it was the wrong number. I got so fucking angry. I grabbed all the paraphernalia, I threw it in the garbage, and I never lit the pipe again, okay? But I still partake. And as you can see, at 75, I guess I'm still kind of together, you know what I mean? So we wrote this song called Between the Lines, because there was a guy we knew, he had a little mirror. He was a dealer, you know? And it had a hologram on the mirror of two coke lines that weren't there. So, you know, we go over to his house, he'd put out like five lines, you know? So there was always somebody who went, and there was nothing. Anyway, it's called Between the Lines, here it comes.
cocaine.
Thank you.
It's called Slow Death.
I know the world.
Thank you very much. We love you. Good night. Thank you so much.